guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Anita. If you're new here, do well to subscribe. If you're a returning subscriber, thanks for always sticking around. In today's video, I'll be sharing with you guys what exactly I moved to the UK with, the foodstuff I packed, and the things I came along with. A lot of you guys will be migrating for several reasons: for schooling, for working, for visits, whatever reason you're migrating for. This video is going to help you know what and what to pack and how exactly to pack them. Most importantly, I'm starting with the food stuff because that's like the most important thing. It's no news that African shops are very expensive and you don't want to spend all your savings on buying food stuff. And with the few experience I've had here tasting foreign meals, man, I think I prefer my African dishes. Maybe with time I'm going to adapt, and I wouldn't want hunger to finish me. So I packed a lot of food stuff, like why coming. Also, I want you to understand that this might differ with respect to the immigration check and what to pass the immigration check. I think it's most dependent on the airline you're going to use. So I used Emirates, and I'm going to show you what exactly I was able to move here. None of my things were seized. So you guys can look around. I really packed a lot, and I'm going to show you guys all of this in this video. So for the sake of clarity and easy package, you'll be needing a Ziploc bag. I think this is like the first thing you should get. Is this how it looks like? So it helps you pack all your things. You're going to be seeing it. So guys, I took this stockfish. I'm from the southeastern part of Nigeria. So most of the foodstuff you might be seeing here, you might not really know about them, but this one is stockfish. It's called Okoroko. I love to use this to make meals. You see, I got a lot of them, and this is the way I packed it. Okay, so guys, I also got corn. I got corn for my sister. She's using that for pap. I got dried scent leaves. This is dried scent leaves. It's called ahimu or nchuanwu in my place. I don't know what it's called in your place. So this can pass. It's dried. I just felt that if I had come along with the wet one, is going to be a bit bulky, so that's why I dried it. So my mom helped me to dry it, so you can as well dry some of your vegetables. Then this is onugbu. This is onugbu, dried bitter leaf. So yes, I packed onugbu, and you guys can see I clearly labeled it dried bitter leaf. Then I packed zobo as well. Zobo, it's called hibiscus. That was what Google told me, I don't know. So that's why I labeled it hibiscus in bracket zobo. I also packed this. This is dried cow skin. Omo. This is also it. Then this is quili quili. I don't know what it's called. I tried to browse it and I saw granite snacks. I don't know, but I brought this. Yes. I also brought this. This is obono. Obono. Obono seed. I think I asked Google and I didn't know what it actually gave me, so I said let me just use obono. I'm not gonna speak the grammar that I will not understand. So this is abacha. This is, I'm a lover of abacha, and I can't imagine staying here without making abacha or buying it at a very high cost, so I got it. So I labeled it cassava flakes. I think that was what Google gave me. So this is it as well. This is cocoyam flour. So you can come along with your cocoyam flour for thickening. I don't know what you use, but this is what I use when I want to make my delicious onugbu soup or oha soup. So this is cocoyam flour and it's used for thickening. So you just have to label it so you wouldn't have issues or whatsoever. It's white in color, you know, so if you know what I mean. This is egusi. This is egusi. Yes, this is melon seed. I got actually 2 buckets of it. It's much. And guys, while packing, consider your weight. Consider the weight of what you are entitled to carry, so you don't have to pay extra baggage. But if you have the money for extra baggage, why not pay and carry everything? So these things here, like, the weight was really much. I had to buy an extra baggage and I also had to cargo some of them. So if you're not ready for all this, don't pack this much quantity. Just like this, I got it 2 custard buckets, if you're familiar with that measurement. So guys, this is crayfish. I bought crayfish, yes, and I also grated some of them. I can't find. Okay, so this is crayfish. I also grated this, so I will start using this before I settle in properly. I wouldn't advise you or you guys to grate everything because I feel it's not just okay for storage reasons. I wouldn't advise you to grate everything that you're coming with. I also brought this. This is dried catfish. I also brought it along, and I also brought this one. I labeled it dried fish, mangala in brackets. So these are the 2 types of fish that I brought along, and I was able to travel with it. Then, so these are my cooking spices. You can see for ease, I just packed them in a Ziploc bag. You can see that there are a lot of them in here. I packed them in this Ziploc bag and I labeled it cooking spices. That way it's much easier. So I also brought this. This is palm ash for cooking. So this is called ungo in my place, ungo. So it's used in place of akamu because they said it's much healthier than akamu. So I brought it. I also brought suya pepper. I brought a lot of this. It's just that some of them got broken, so I'm trying to clean up the mess. So I brought this. I also brought this. This is ogiri obi, yes. And because it smells a lot, I kept it in this container and covered it airtight. So this is another one. If you're coming in with things that smell so awfully but taste so nice, you put them in an airtight container. That way, when you cover it tight, it's not going to smell until you open it. Like if I open this one here. So this is just the way I packed this one. Yes, I came with granules. I can't find the other bottle. Be around. I came with this. I came with also this. This is oba. I labeled it grounded barbara nuts, if I'm pronouncing it correctly. Enugu people. Queen. I'm not from Enugu, I'm from Anambra. So this is our popular okpa. I brought it along as well. Guys, I also came with this okpaka. Are you surprised? So I kept the three in a Ziploc bag. I have unpacked it because I refrigerated it. So I just brought it out from the fridge now. So this is okpaka. Don't be surprised. You can come along with anything so long as you pack it properly, the right way. This is ogiri. Is it oil? I don't know what this is called, but this smells so badly, but it tastes so nice. So I came with two of this. This is it. And I think what I labeled the Ziploc is local spices, so I pinned it properly so that it doesn't smell. Also guys, I came with this dried Cameroon pepper. You can see the way I labeled it. Yes, dry Cameroon pepper. Also guys, I came with this is local spice. They are all local spices. This is efu, that's what we call it, ehuru. Then oziza seed. I don't know what you guys call it, but if you're from my place, Anambra State, I think you should be familiar with all these things I just mentioned now. Guys, another thing I came in here with is this. Lots of them. This. Okay, so I was thinking this thing didn't have much weight, but I think this was weighing about 5 kg when I put all of them together. So I came with this. It really doesn't matter. If you have money to pay for extra baggage, just pack all your things and come. I think it's much easier. So guys, the next thing is your personal stuff. I would advise you, when you're coming, don't come with lots and lots of clothes. My sister actually advised me not to pack a lot, so I came in with few clothes. I came in with few clothes, few shoes that I would be wearing to work until I settle in properly. Then I also came with, yes, your documents. You wouldn't forget that, no way. Because when you come in, you're going to still be checked. So if you're coming here to work, they will request for a letter which was given to you at your visa collection center. Then your passport. Who will travel without a passport? Going to come in with some of your valuable documents, the ones you really need. If you're coming for schooling, you come with maybe your statement of results, your all that. That's I think that's not the angle I want to go to, because I'm not here for schooling. I'm here to work. So you come in with whatever document that is valid. Don't just load up your primary school results and all that, because obviously it's not necessary, or your secondary school results. Just come with your necessary documents. Then clothing, I've already said that, just come with few clothes, because when you pack all these things, my sister told me that it will get to a point where you wouldn't be needing the old clothes again. So you carry all your old palaver and come here and start looking for how to dispose them. So just dispose your Nigerian palaver, whatever, wherever country you're coming from, just keep them. Come with a little that would sustain you for the time being, so that when you start earning, of course you buy clothes for yourself and buy shoes for yourself. Also guys, while coming in, come along with your medications. Don't for the ladies as well, don't forget your wigs. Carry them along as much as you can lay your hands on. Guys, I won't rule out the fact that the whole stress, the whole hassle involved in trying to move, immigration check and all that, is solely dependent on your airline. Yes, some airlines, they can give wahala. But I used Emirates and it wasn't really stressful at all. Believe me, it wasn't stressful at all. In fact, my hand luggage, I think that was what they even opened to check. That was at the last point before I boarded. That was just the only thing that was checked. So I don't know. I see videos where people said they were being searched and all that. I did not experience, and my bag wasn't even opened. So I don't know what they meant by their things being disarranged at the airport, and I didn't experience that. And I just pray none of you would experience such. So just check, ask questions about any airline before you use it, so you don't get so worked up at the airport trying to put your things together because of one check or another. I don't know. So guys, we've come to the end of this video. I hope this video was helpful. Do well to subscribe if you've not subscribed at this point. Like this video, share this video, and I always love you if you do that. Also guys, feel free to ask me questions under the comment section. Don't forget to turn on your notification bell so you get notified at any time I post any video, because I'm going to be posting a lot of helpful videos. See you guys in my next video.